Hi guys, welcome to another video. This time it's about my bullet journal setup for 2019 and I'm very excited if you like my setup because it's my second try. So I hope it's a good start, but I want to say first it's not so complete bullet journal setup because it's otherwise a really really long video, so I cut out some parts and I will show you in another video a flip through because like I said, it's really really long and I wanted to make it a little shorter. So I show you at the beginning the book I had printed on lulu.com so I can set it up with a layout, and that should help me a little bit with the whole process of planning. So you have at the beginning some pages for the index and keys. I don't know if I really make keys. I just wrote it down at the start, but maybe I will change it later because I know what my keys are. It's not that hard. So, and then you have the yearly overview where I have made some notes, like which month I start with the January, of course, because it's no year, with what vacation days I already have taken and which one are free to use. Then I made some notes, like I did some pencil sketching when the day is a Sunday, and I also overdrew the 29th of February with a little monster, so that I think I don't have to see the 29th February and have a little cute design in it. Then the goals page comes, where I have written down the my goals for 2019 and 2024, and we have the monthly overview for January. I don't know why, but because I don't really like to read dresses, but I really wanted to draw some. So I top off it as my theme for January. And you also, when you make something real fashion, you need like something like scissors or something else to sew it. So I made a little design out of it. And yes, I hope you like it a little bit. It's my first design for a bullet journal month, so I wanted to try to use it for the weekly overview as well. But to finish the monthly overviews, I would write down the day of the week on top of the squares, and then I write down in the circle which number it is, and then in the end I have some boxes left I can use for goals or for stuff I have no day at the moment, like I must go to the dentist, for example, but I don't have a date where I can go, or I don't have a date where here is time. So yes, I can write it down there, and I want to color the days I post something on YouTube with red, and when I made something else, like when I make a new episode for my webcomic or something else. I have some more notes on it. So, and then we have the weekly overviews. I will write down the days from start to finish of the week over the as a header, and then I will write down it in each box a day, and I have 8 boxes, so I can use the left box for goals or for the week. And then I want to write in the right corner, I don't want to write something in the right corner. I want to draw something like figure, and I top of it that when I want to use dresses as my theme, that I can make a little background with some patterns, for example. But you will see this later. I just write down the important parts right now because the video will otherwise be really really long. So, and then on the end we have the monthly finances with income and expenses and the online shopping tracker. So, and I hope I don't need the complete side of the online chat topic tracker. I want to write a little less in the book. So, and then we have after the whole year extra pages. I want to track down in which movies I did go in the cinema, because I have a card that I pay a monthly fee, and I want to see if the use of it really helps me save some money, or if I pay on top of that. And on the other page, I will write down which books I had to read this year, or maybe to say it right, next year. So I made a bookcase with 4 parts, so that I can write down the books of every 3 months. And when I will fill it up with the time I just wrote to some books. And even when I don't read 7 books in the first 3 months, I can color it in one color, so that I know I didn't read a book, but I have a nice design on it. Then I have the physical training page, so that I can make a little bit more of physical training and write down some notes. So then we have the payoff plan, where I have my debt I want to pay back on it. I wanted to make it in one shot, but the page was too short, so I split it up, so I can write down left and on the right in which months I paid which part back. So like when I paid 100 euro back on the 1st January of 2019, I can make a note, or if I pay back 500 euro next month, I can write it down as well. Then we have the presents page, or the gift page, like you want to say it, so that I can write down which presents I already have bought, or what I want to buy for a special person, or for the Christmas presents, because I have the habit that I buy something a few months before, because I have seen something nice for a person, and then I totally forget that I have this present and buy something else as well, and then I have 2 presents. Then I have a little page for my little brother, because I buy him books really often, so I can write down from the books, because there are not one shots, there are most of the time are series, so I can write down which books I already have I already gave him as a present, and which I have here but didn't give him as a present. I can make a little structure, so I can see the difference. So this will go as well. Then I have some to-do lists and a double page for art ideas that I can also use, and the social media tracker for my YouTube channel, and maybe something else like my Instagram account or Webtoons account. I will see. I really want to write down for YouTube, because it starts a little bit to grow. I'm very proud, even when it's not that big, but maybe it's a little bit more motivation for me. And also I want to write down for every month what watch hour I have and how many subscribers I have, so that I can track a little bit how much people or how much watch hour grows over which month. So then we have the social media pages, where I write down all the pages I am currently on it, so that I can, when I post something, I can look down on which page I didn't post it. I mean, it sounds easy, but over the time, I sometimes forgot to post something on the other side. And I want to write down some challenges. So then we have YouTube workflow pages. There will come 6 double pages where I can write down on which day which video is uploaded, and how far I am with some videos. I think that will help me a little bit with my work, so that I know how much I'm in the process, and when I have more than one video at the moment, because sometimes I film 3 videos at a time. Then, of course, YouTube idea pages shouldn't be left out because sometimes you have an idea but no time at the moment to film it. And at the end, what I was missing in other bullet journal videos, that because I really like to watch other bullet journal videos as well, we have on the left side, I made some story pages so that I have a little space where I can draw the color of the story that I will write down on an extra page, and then I can track how much pages are already written down. But to be informed, the pages are not the same like in episode, because I don't know yet how much episodes are a page, because I didn't really try it out yet. So it's my my project for the future, but I think it will help me to see which stories I didn't have written down yet and how far I am with some pages, because when I really would be finished with some stories, I would color the following numbers with a black or a green tone, for example, or another color, so that I have a color for episodes that are finished at 12, like short comics I have on my list. So, like I said, the following page will I use for story ideas, where I would write down the currently title. To most of my stories, the title is the only thing that is finished. and some other stories I have that are not have a finished title, I will write down as well, so I have a little overview of all the stories at the moment. And then I have another comic parts page, where I write down some parts that are not really in an episode of a comic but are really important, like character sheets, where you have a full body view of some parts or some details of the character, so that you can draw it over and over again and it looks always the same. And other things like do you have made a family tree or social tree, like the interaction with other characters? Because as the longer the story is, I think the more it's confusing how the interaction really did go at the moment. And at the end, I have another overview for one comic. At the moment, for one webcomic, where I can write down which episode is how far finished, so I can write down if I had already made a character sheet and if the title or the logo is finished, and the backgrounds and the thumbnails, the line arts, the colors, and of course the finished episode. So I know when I have made a little bit more for the webcomic, how far I am really in the stories, how much is finished, and did I already upload it, so that when I want to upload recently or something else, when I have my webcomic really far, like 10 episodes, that I have a little puffer that I am not like yet. When I have uploaded one episode, then you have 6 months nothing. I think that's a little bit better. So that I can see on both sides with some story is how far I have used my scissors and cut out the other page part, so that are not the pages are overlooked. So, and I will stop it here. I think that's enough. And I hope I see you in the next video again with the flip through. And I hope you have happy holidays. And until the next video, I say bye.